Welcome at the Anki Education Center. Here it's where everything started and still goes on actually. The building is rebuilt like 11 years ago, 12 maybe, before it was like started as an indoor and rebuilt it to a really nice place, I think. So I'll show you what it is like in the inside. Bonfire really had a special place in my heart because when I started him, I got him when he was 3, and I had him until he was 30. It's 27 years. It's such a big part of your life that he was so important for me. He always gets to me again.
Ik wilde per se hier afscheid nemen omdat het eigenlijk ons concours is. Aantal overwinningen gehad. Begonnen hier. Ik wilde eigenlijk maar één ding zeggen. Ik geloof dat ik het grootste geluk van de wereld heb mee mogen maken om een paard zoals Bonfire te mogen hebben. Die voor mij door het vuur is gegaan, 10 jaar lang het beste heeft gedaan wat hij kon. Vergeet hem niet.
I'm getting really emotional when I see Bonfire again, so I could cry at the moment actually. As you could see, he's a very special horse. He stands there like he's so always like that. The moment he had to go, he was there, but relaxed. He was relaxed, and I thought I'm not gonna cry because you know it's not a farewell. It's for the people, but not for me. But I got really emotional, and looking at it now, I get really emotional again. A horse, once in a lifetime horse, you think at that moment. Okay, later Salinero came and. Was another lifetime, once in a lifetime horse, but then the second one. The most important horse at the moment, in my opinion, of my barn, it's Salinero. He's getting a bit gray. He's, I guess, 27 years old at the moment. I rode him until he was 25. And now he's retired. Probably everybody knows, but just to make sure you don't forget about him, he won the Olympics in 2004 in Athens, and then he won the Olympics 2008 in Hong Kong as well, so I'm very proud of him. And then when he was 18 years old, actually it was not in my plan, but I took him to the Olympics in London 2012, because he was needed to bring in the team bronze for the Dutch team. And he did, so that was his last competition, the Olympics. Then we retired him during the Dutch Masters. He got his farewell. You know it's a farewell for the horses, but what I now remember is that after the farewell on Saturday, okay, the whole press is there, and I didn't want to get off Salinero. I think I knew that for me it was more also the end of my really dressage career. It took me another 15 minutes to really get off him because I didn't want to, you know, I knew this was the last time really at the competition riding him. Yeah, when I get off, it's gone. Yeah, okay, you think it's only horses here that are having their retirements. It's not completely true, but a little bit it is. Yes, it is. Yes, Wiz. I don't think I'm going to compete at the Dutch Masters again because it's impossible to be chairman and a rider at the same event because you have to look nice being a chairman and as a rider, it's hard when you take your hat off. Oh no, helmet at the moment. Nee, I don't think I'm going to ride there anymore, but that's fine for me. I like it because it's my competition and I'm really, for me it's very important that the competition is there. I'm really proud to be the chairman. It's completely different from being a rider at the competition. And okay, I'm better in being the rider, I still think, because I know there what to do. On the other hand, it's nice to be the chairman, so I can, because I really have the feeling I'm in the Brabant, the Dutch Masters is a part of me as a rider. So now I can do something back for this competition. But really emotional moment. Because I never thought the Dutch Masters had to cancel the competition.